In this recording, I'm going to talk about the accuracy of SolidWorks, of a BIM calculation, while trying to compare it to theoretical results. So I've set up a beam of 1 meter in length here with the weldment feature. When having done that, I've chosen a big tube of 273 millimeters in outer diameter. And when I use the weldment feature, then SolidWorks simulation will automatically set up a beam calculation for me. So I can see that over here. I've set up the beam calculation. Now I'm gonna compare the results of the beam calculation to a theoretical calculation that I've done with this table. That in this case it comes out of the Hibbler book. I'm gonna calculate this situation of a distributed load, and I'm gonna compare that then to the SolidWorks simulation results. So first I've set up my model, I've created an E-modulus and combined it with a section modulus of this area. So I can have a look at the section properties over here, tools, and then section properties. And I find that I've got a moment of inertia of this area of this value. And I've created this section and the combination with the mode of elasticity, so that it's easily for me to compare it to theoretical results. So if I set up an Excel calculation over here, and this is the situation I'm going to calculate. I'm going to switch to this screen now. So this is the situation. It's a Q load, a distributed load, and I'm going to calculate this situation here, and I've combined the E and I value so that it gives a nice rounded value when multiplying these values together, and in that way it's easy for me to compare the SolidWorks results with the theoretical results. So I've changed the E modulus a little bit. You can see it over here when I look at the properties of the materials. I've changed it a little bit from steel to a bit of a higher value to create a nice combination of E times I. All right, so I've got a study set up over here. I've got my fixtures. I've fixed this point while giving it the possibility to rotate in almost every direction. You can see here that it's not allowed to rotate because of this arrow over here. It's not allowed to rotate around its own axis, so that's all right. And on the other end, I've created a reference geometry as well, which I can have translate in the X direction. So the X direction I left free with this button, which is not pressed in. So you can change that by pressing in and out this value. Now it's allowed to move in the X direction. So then I've already entered a Q load. In this case, I'm gonna have a look over here, of 10,000 newton per meter. I can change that here. Let me see. I can't change that here. I should do that in the options of simulation in that case. But anyway, it's 10 newton per millimeter, which equals to 10,000 newtons per meter, which is the way it works for a distributed load. So then I've already run this simulation. I can run it again. It doesn't really matter. It doesn't take that long. And after running it, we can have a look at displacement, and that's what I want to compare. So having a look at the displacement, I see that exactly the right value here in this simulation. The reason for that is that I've switched off the effects of the shear in this tube. And when I don't do that, these results will not be comparable to the theoretical results. I can show you how to change that. When I go here and I change the definition of the beam. Here I've got the section properties. I didn't run into this for a long time because this effect only starts getting stronger when the tube is short compared to its diameter, which in this case happens to be the case. So then when I enter a value of zero, the results will be very comparable to the theory, while the default SolidWorks settings, they show up when I push reset over them. Then it takes shear into account, and when calculating then, you get a whole different set of results. You will see that the deformation will be a lot bigger because it also takes the shear effects of this Q load into account. Here I'm going to switch to the displacement plot again, and now you can see it's a lot bigger. It's now 1.6 e minus 2 millimeters, while before it was 1.3, which is a change of about 45%. So going back, I'm gonna change the definition again here. I've only changed one beam right now. If I change them both, it will be the difference of 45%. In this case, I'm gonna go back to this definition and then use the section properties again with a shear factor of zero here too. And in this case, I can exactly compare it to the theoretical results, and then it seems to be really accurate as well. I'm gonna have a look at that. Here's the displacement plot. This is the value that I found with SolidWorks. Here's the calculated value in this Excel file. I've copied an image of the formula to calculate the deformation here. This is the theoretical results. I've multiplied 5 with a Q load of 10. Here you see it all. This is L to the third and fourth. I'm calculating in millimeters, so it's a beam of 1 meter, which turns out to 1,000 to the fourth millimeters to the squared. Here I've got all the other values, the E modulus, the I section modulus that I showed in SolidWorks previously. Here I see then the theoretical results of calculating these three values together, which will turn out to be this number, and these two three values, which turns out to be this number. I've divided them to get the exact theoretical results. Here I've got the SolidWorks result, and the difference is very small. This is the percentage, so it's very much neglectable. A very high accuracy here in SolidWorks calculation. I can also do this calculation with websites. I've verified the results there as well, and this is exactly the right results that I should actually get. Then of course you can also plot the ND and M lines. You do that with the beam diagrams, so you can get for example a moment plot of this beam. I always have to guess which one it is, direction 1 or direction 2, I never know. Just have a guess, and let me see, this is the right one. So this is the moment. It's the biggest in the center of the beam and smaller in the outer side of the beam. Beam diagram, and then let me look at the other moment. So this one was the right plot. You see the moment in this beam in this case. So that's it. The accuracy in SolidWorks is very high, but when using short beams, you should pay attention to this error definition value when comparing it to theoretical results. So the SolidWorks will take into account the shear, which is more accurate, but in that case you can't compare it to the theoretical results that you can calculate with a Hibbler table or a formula table that you can find for beams on a lot of websites as well. So that's the end of this recording.